मायोकार्डियल इस्कीमिया, एक्यूट मायोकार्डियल इस्कीमिया। फॉर दिस वी विल कंसिडर अ पेशेंट विथ एथेरोस्क्लेरोटिक नैरोइंग ऑफ द कोरोनरी वेसल्स। ही इज कंफर्टेबल एट रेस्ट बट ऑन एक्सरसाइज गेट्स एंजाइनल पेन। What happens is that after exercise, the myocardial demand increases, but sufficient blood cannot reach the myocardium due to partially obstructed coronary arteries. So there is acute myocardial ischemia, seen on the ECG in the form of ST segment depression, which disappears with rest when the demand reduces. This ECG in lead V5 shows a ST depression of 2 millimeters during an attack of angina. The same lead in the same patient after a few hours shows isoelectric ST segment. This is the typical change in angina pectoris. There is plain or downward sloping ST segment depression which is temporary. Now compare the effect of myocardial infarction as seen on the right. When a coronary vessel gets blocked causing an infarct, ECG shows ST segment elevation in the leads facing the infarcted area. While in acute myocardial ischemia, as seen on the left, ECG shows a temporary ST segment depression. Acute myocardial ischemia is also seen during stress test or exercise test. In a positive stress test, there will be a depression of ST segments in the leads facing the ischemic area. The changes are most prominently seen in V5 and V6. In this ECG, the ST segment shows a horizontal and downward sloping depression of 1 mm after exercise. This is a positive sign of myocardial ischemia. The criteria for diagnosing myocardial ischemia are: number 1, the J point should be depressed by at least 1 millimeter, and number 2, the depressed ST segment should be horizontal or downward sloping but not upward sloping. Only if the J point depression is more than 2 millimeters, then upward sloping ST segment may be considered as pathological. Just as in myocardial infarction, if these changes are seen in leads 1 AVL V4 to V6, it indicates ischemia of the anterior wall of left ventricle. And if these changes are seen in leads 2, 3 AVF, it indicates ischemia of inferior wall. But if more than one coronary vessels are blocked, the changes will be seen in many leads. For example, in this strip, they are seen in 2, 3 AVF, as well as V4, V5 and V6. The ischemic changes are never seen in leads V1 and V2. The ST segment depression in leads V1 or V2 may be seen only in right ventricular hypertrophy with strain and in true posterior wall infarctions. At this stage, let us see the various types of ST segment depressions. This is horizontal or plain ST segment depression with sharp angle with the T wave. This signifies myocardial ischemia. This is a upward sloping ST segment depression and is a variant of normal. It is significant only if the J point is depressed by 2 millimeters or more. This is called horizontality of ST segment, where the ST segment remains absolutely horizontal and isoelectric and makes a sharp angle with the T wave. This is an early manifestation of ischemia. This is a downward sloping ST segment which indicates severe ischemia, but it is also seen in digitalis toxicity. This is a sagging concave upwards ST segment, also suggestive of ischemia. Non-acute myocardial ischemia. Note the slight ST depression and symmetrical T wave inversion in lead V5 of this ECG. In acute ischemia, we saw that the patient with narrowed coronary arteries shows ST segment depression during stress test and during anginal attack. But if the ECG is taken at rest, when there are no symptoms, what will we see? In many of the patients, there will be no change at all. That is, the ECG of a patient with partially obstructed coronary arteries may be perfectly normal. But in others, some ischemic changes will be present. The commonest change is slight ST segment depression and inversion or flattening of the T waves in leads V5 and V6, just like the strain pattern in left ventricular hypertrophy. So if the leads V5 and V6 show ST segment depression and flat or inverted T waves in a patient without left ventricular hypertrophy, myocardial ischemia should be suspected. The second change that may be seen is inversion of T waves in anterior or posterior limb leads. Note the T wave inversions in leads 2, 3 and AVF. In the absence of chest pain or infarct, T wave inversion suggests myocardial ischemia and their location suggests the area of ischemia. So this ECG suggests ischemia of the inferior wall, that is, narrowing of posterior descending branch of right coronary artery. So to summarize, non-acute ischemia may be diagnosed from ST segment depression in leads V5 and V6 with flattening or inversion of T waves and T wave inversion in limb leads.